All right, this is just embarrassing. You know, I really hoped 2024 would be a change of form for Star Wars games, but between the disastrous launch of the Battlefront Classic Collection and now this completely deserved ratio on the Star Wars Outlaws trailer, I'm kind of glad I started to distance myself from this franchise. Don't get me wrong, I still love Star Wars, but between the apathy for the shows and the movies, and with these publishers apparently being so tone-deaf that they're killing their own chances of success with the games, I just don't see how anything short of George Lucas himself coming back can right this ship. So what's going on with Star Wars Outlaws? Well, I'm a few days late to this news. I wanted to let it simmer a bit and see what the general thoughts of the people were. But the more I dug into this game, the more I realized just how deep the controversy actually goes. There isn't any one thing that people are upset about, but it's a multi-layered problem that, when all added up, makes for one of the absolute worst reveals I've seen for a game in a long time. And naturally, it had to be another Star Wars game, so let's get into it. Why all the controversy around Star Wars Outlaws? 34,000 likes to 122,000 dislikes. That went up since the last time I checked it. It was at 116,000 dislikes last time I checked. So players clearly think the game is trash, right? Well, actually, no. If we look at the top comments on the trailer here, virtually none of them talk about the game itself, or even the trailer, really. Almost all of these comments are about Ubisoft, the publisher, and their historically shady business practices. Let's just read some of these so you can get the idea. She has a higher microtransaction count than even Master Yoda. Face it, Ubisoft, you just need to be comfortable with people not buying your games anymore. And of course, this is in reference to a quote made by a Ubisoft executive where they at one point said gamers should get used to the idea of not owning their games. This is a single-player game with day one DLC. That means the $70 price tag does not include chunks of the game that are already finished. Insane behavior. We'll touch on that later. This is why YouTube hides dislikes. Not from me! Ubisoft already murdered their own brand. The ratio is deserved. Buying equals not owning. Pirating equals not stealing. Okay, I think you guys get the idea. These are jaded fans who've just been burned over and over again by this company, and they're sick of it. This has nothing to do with the game itself. That's not to say there isn't specific in-game reasons that some fans are not too thrilled with this reveal. In my research for this, I did the one thing that I told myself I would never, ever, 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 ever do again. I went on Twitter. And the conversation there was a little bit different than on the story trailer comment section. A lot of what people were talking about on Twitter had to do with the main character's appearance and how she looks so much different from the actress who plays her. Umberlee Gonzalez is drop-dead gorgeous, and she plays K-Vess in the game, but the Twitter crowd was really focused on the physical downgrade of the character compared to her actress. This actually touches on a bigger talking point about the quote-unquote uglification of women in video games, where there's this narrative that video game developers and publishers are going out of their way to make the female characters in their games look unattractive, or as unattractive as they can make them. And this has been backed up with a ton of examples over the years. It's further demonstrated when you have male characters who look exactly like, or even better than, their actor who plays them. And when you see enough of it, it does start to kind of make you wonder. I'm not saying I subscribe to this idea. I'm not saying I don't subscribe to it. It's definitely a bit of an internet conspiracy theory, but I'm just saying it's interesting, and it does make me scratch my head. Then we have people in the industry who brag about wanting to eliminate the male gaze, not homosexual dudes, you know, the male gaze. Personally, I don't even think Kay looks that bad, especially when compared to some of these other characters that we've got over the years. But that's just the issue right there. It's the fact that this has been happening, that this is even a conversation to begin with. It's just more ammunition for that gun, and Twitter is burning through mags. That wasn't the only thing I found on Twitter. This next one was pretty egregious, and I completely understand why people were upset. We actually had a racist, sexist community manager on our hands for this game, ladies and gentlemen. That's right, the community manager, the person who manages the community. Yeah, they apparently have a thing for specifically bashing on white dudes at any chance they get. I'm not gonna read these posts. If you wanna pause the video, you can read them for yourself. But when we live in this climate where gamers are concerned about DEI hires and ESG scores being put on a pedestal before making a good game, when we see stuff like this, it just makes us go, yeah, that's absolutely what's going on. Who says this? Needless to say, this person made their Twitter private, so I wasn't personally able to vet these tweets, but the screenshot was circulating and that's where I pulled it from. It's just not a good look, no matter how you chalk it up, and the fact this person was hired, let alone was in charge of community relations, just reflects even more poorly on Ubisoft. Let's go back to that whole thing about not owning your own media that you buy, because there is a wider problem within Ubisoft that has also unfortunately infected Star Wars Outlaws, and that's how players will need an internet connection to download the game, even if they bought the physical copy. You might be thinking, what's the problem? Everyone has internet, and touche. But this just means that that physical disc is virtually worthless. If you need an internet connection to install the game, then what's even on the disc? Just the installer? The only way people get to keep playing this is if Ubisoft continues to host it. Once they decide not to host it, then the game is gone forever. And without that physical copy to anchor you, you will have lost all the money, all the time spent on this game. This just recently happened with another Ubisoft game, The Crew. Ubisoft is no longer supporting it and completely pulled it. Now it's lost to the sands of time. All that money, all that time, gone. This is what they mean when the Ubisoft suit says, we need to get comfortable with not owning our games. You will own nothing and be happy about it. This now brings us to what I think is the ultimate slap in the face to the consumers, and the main reason that people are shredding this trailer. The price for this game is laughable. It's an actual joke when you see what their scheme is here. Base game, 70 bucks. No issues there. That's been the standard for a little bit now. All good. Gold edition, which gets you some cosmetic goodies, an exclusive mission tied to a season pass. We'll talk about that in a second. And 3-day early access, 110 bucks. All right. Then we've got the ultimate edition for the mere cost of $145 after tax. You get everything in the gold edition, some extra cosmetics, and a digital art book. All right. Ubisoft, why is there a season pass in a single player game? Why is there exclusive content locked behind a paywall on day one? Does this mean that there's gonna be a season two that we're gonna have to shell out another extra 40 bucks for if we want that content? Second of all, who greenlit these bundles? Because this price does not justify what you're getting. Do you see what they're doing here? It goes back to what that one comment said. They're depriving players of in-game content if they don't pay the premium price. That's literally what this is, because they could have just as easily not done a day one DLC like this. This exclusive Jabba's Gambit mission that comes with the gold and ultimates, that could have easily been in the base game. In fact, my cynical mind tells me that they took that out of the base game just so they could package it as a DLC like this and sell it back to us for a premium. This is the scummy business practices that all those commenters were talking about, and why this game is getting ratioed into oblivion on YouTube right now. But oh, it gets better once you realize that these absurd prices are intentional and are clearly a way to funnel people into getting their subscription service, Ubisoft Plus. They're legit trying to price people out of this. They don't want you buying this or this. They want you buying this because in the long haul, this is what will get them more money. They're banking on players getting the subscription service, forgetting about it, and then getting that charge for 18 bucks a month. If that subscription on that one player stays active for a full year, they've already made more money off that one person than they would have if they bought the Ultimate Edition. Now, all's fair in love and war. I try to be as fair as I possibly can. From one perspective, I can kind of understand why Ubisoft is doing this. Last year, the company reported losses of over 500 million US dollars. Their latest quadruple A attempt was a huge flop, and I'm sure that lost them even more. They're desperately trying to recoup some of those losses, and this seems to be the genius way they're doing it, by once again nickel and diming players for the bare minimum. And that, ladies and gentlemen, is everything that I could find on the controversy around Star Wars Outlaws. What are your thoughts, though? Let me know in a comment. If you saw anything else that players were upset about, or if I missed something in this video, let me know. It's just sad, man. I was really looking forward to Star Wars Outlaws, and I'm not gonna say that the game is dead on arrival. It very well could be. This initial response is not good at all. This is actually a really bad look for the game. And it just sucks that this keeps happening to Star Wars. We haven't had a good Star Wars announcement, I feel like, since Jedi Survivor. Jedi Survivor was the last one that went off without a hitch. There was no controversy around that game, except for the performance issues after launch. That's really the only thing I can think of that Jedi Survivor had negative going for it. I'm not really too sure what Ubisoft can do to fix this. other than maybe getting rid of that day one DLC and just including it in the overall bundle, they legit took content out of the game just to sell it back to us, man. This is stupid. All right, that's all I got for you guys today. I hope you enjoyed this video. Kind of a more low-key, different style than what I usually do. I'm trying to get better at freestyling and just freeballing my scripts into the microphone because I think it's more authentic. You get a better sense of just me as opposed to, you know, reading off a script. But yeah, that's all for today. Hope you guys have a great rest of your day, and I will see you in the next one. Peace.